Good morning.
Good morning.
Oops. Welcome everyone to our Sunday morning service of worship. It's good to see you. I must admit, I'm part two from Fitzstuart, and as I was trying to make my way down the pavement, it was very slippery, so I went over into the hotel. So well done that you've made it here. I realise you've come with a degree of risk attending church this Sunday morning. But good to see you. And I'd like to start by thanking Yvonne and Sheila for leading worship last Sunday morning at very short notice, a week ago yesterday, as my dear wife Carol thought I was worse than usual. And
that sounds like a COVID call.
Yes.
Carol
suggested a test for COVID, and sure enough, the result was positive. And so that's why I phoned Sheila and the board, and they stepped in, and I've been able to see the service, and they did a wonderful job. So thanks very much to Sheila and Yvonne for leading worship. So it's very tempting to phone again this morning, but here I am. So, no, it's good to be with you once again for this, Christmas service. Of course, next Sunday is Christmas Day, and we have a celebration today that we hope will be interesting for all ages, all folks attending. And then, of course, next Saturday is Christmas Eve, and at 6 o'clock we have our Jubilee for All Christmas Eve All Age Worship Service, and folks have been preparing way for that, and it's always a very enjoyable occasion. And then next Saturday evening at 11:15 there is our Watch Night Service to bring in Christmas Day. And then on Christmas Day itself, next Sunday, we meet at 10:30 for our Christmas Day celebration of worship. I think everything else is clear in the intonations, and you're welcome to the week. There is a beer and carol service at the Dutch Mill on Tuesday evening at 6. When it was planned, we didn't realise it was going to be the same evening as the Aberdeen Rangers match. Was that true? But anyway, we'll see how it all works out. It's great. We have these plans, and then things just develop in ways that we hadn't foreseen. You're invited to join in the responses in bold print. A love that never ceases, a creativity that designed the universe, a hope that cannot be quenched, a pursuit of reconciliation no matter the cost. These are the things that are of God. Then let us worship God. And to sing God's praise, Once in Royal David City, in the first verse, it will be sung as a solo, and so we stand at the beginning, and then as a congregation we join in the second verse, Once in Royal David City.
Thank you.
our rejection and hurt who hold us here today in acceptance and love. Come, God, for us, who in a gentle voice whispers in our ears that we, each one of us, are beloved children. Come, God, under us, who cradles us in arms that never grow weary, whose lap has room enough for all. Come, God, over us, who watches in the long silence of the night, that we might rest in peace. Come, God, beside us, who steadies us when we falter, who lifts us up when we fall. Come, God, behind us, who picks up all the faded dreams we drop along the way and patchworks them into hope. O come, Emmanuel, and we will rejoice forever. Amen. So, sorry, it's Verna, my apologies, who's going to read for us from the book of Isaiah. Thank you, Verna. We're now going to hear our first anthem today from the choir, which is Christmas. Thanks to Hamish Mitchell, the author of the lyrics of Christmas lights. Now, part of what we heard about in, from the prophet Isaiah, oh, I realize I haven't put in my original service the lighting of the Advent candles. I think we better light the Advent candles before we finish the service.
Oh, but we're not quite here.
But anyone who would want to take a turn lighting an Advent candle today, Cameron, did you? I know you graciously gave you a turn over to another young man the other day, but anyone as well as Cameron? Louise, I believe you were up last Sunday, but I'm sure you could come up again and get it, please. Okay, you want to light one of those candles? Almost. It's quite tall, it's quite high for you, I see. That's well done. Persevere, well done. Okay, Cameron. Thank you. It's an all-age service, there's no age limit. Oh, right, Verna, yes, and Sheila. Right. So we heard from one of the prophets called Isaiah, and there was a word in that reading that we might find a bit strange. It's a Hebrew word, and it's Emmanuel. And there are hymns that speak about will come or come Emmanuel. And Emmanuel, it's a funny word, it's not a word we tend to use in our everyday conversation, but it's Hebrew for God with us. That's what we celebrate at Christmas, is God coming into the world in human form. Firstly, it's baby Jesus who grew to be a man, and he taught people, and he healed people, and he showed his love for the world in very special ways. So we're going to actually see a video of this theme, God with us. Now, I know several years ago, Cameron and Rosie and others were in the family were involved in a Lego nativity. So maybe the idea came from yourselves, I'm not sure, but the Church of Scotland have released a video, and I thought it was a really good video telling the Christmas story, and so we're going to see that now.
Christmas began. God's people were waiting for God's special plan. And they'd wondered for years how this plan would unfurl, till an angel appeared to a young teenage girl. Though Mary was troubled, the angel proclaimed, "You found favour with God, do not be afraid. You will conceive and give birth to a son. Call his name Jesus, the King has now come." "I am the Lord's servant," she said in belief. But when Joseph found out, he was filled up with grief. For Mary and Joseph had not yet got married. What would people think of this baby she carried? An angel of God came to him in a dream and helped Joseph see it was not as it seemed. It was God's Holy Spirit that brought life within. This baby had come to save people from sin. So Joseph and Mary and baby-to-be set off to Bethlehem, as was decreed. But when they arrived, there was nowhere to stay, no more rooms to be found for this babe on the way. And then soon the time came she gave birth to a son. The long-promised king had now finally come. And they weren't in a palace, all cosy and warm, where the animals feed was where this king was born. And while crowds in the town were all still fast asleep, there were shepherds nearby, watching over their sheep. Until something disturbed the darkness of night, an angel appeared and the sky filled with light. The glory of God all around them displayed. The angel declared, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause you great joy. The Saviour is born as a baby, a boy." The shepherds saw angels sing glory and peace, and they said to each other, "Now let's go and see." They hurried to find this great King of the Jews. Then in awe and amazement, they spread the good news. Now far in the east, men most clever and wise had seen a strange star that was starting to rise. They knew that a king was the cause of this star, so they set off to find him and followed it far, till it stopped at the place where the boy would be found, and in wonder and worship they humbly bowed down. They opened their treasures, and what did they bring? But frankincense, gold, and myrrh for a king. A king who was little, a king who could cry, who was fragile and feeble, and one day would die. The powerful king who'd been promised for years, who would share in our suffering and take up our tears. For though he was rich, God chose to be poor. He made himself nothing so we could be sure that God is now with us. The King has come near. Good news for all people. Jesus is here.
I think that's a beautifully done version of the Christmas story. So I hope you enjoyed that. And I think it may be on the Church of Scotland website if you want to see it again. And we continue in our worship. We're going to hear a song that celebrates that very theme of God coming down into the world. He came down that we might have love. And I think some of our musicians from the Jubilee Music Group are going to accompany us in the singing of this song. He came down that we might have love.
Listen and enjoy this one, the Virgin Mary and the baby boy.
He's
wrong, you know, because you know the words. They're just not on the screen, so join it. Join it. Leave everybody joining it. It's actually, if you want to, there's 300 of you, if you want to get a book. Feel free to join it.
Joseph named him Jesus. Thanks be to God.
Now, something we celebrate at Christmas is often the light of God coming into the world, and I think we feel that especially in this part of the world, in Europe, with the dark winters, and that sense of light coming into the world. And of course, we mark it in different ways. Here we have it through the Advent candles that we light over the four Sundays of Advent, and then on Christmas Day, the light in the centre representing Jesus coming into the world. And of course, we depend on light in many ways, and of course, this is a very difficult time for some people because of the cost of fuel, of electricity, and of gas. But anyway, I just wonder if anyone has any ideas how we experience light, how do we observe light, or how is light passed on? Any thoughts? Because there's many different ways. So if you can think of one.
A torch.
A torch, yes. Let's see if I've managed a torch in my wee bag. I've managed my hat, but that doesn't have a light on it. But never mind. Anyway, let's see. Yes, a torch. That's right. So a torch can be very useful, particularly if the electricity goes and we're not able to turn the switches on. But, well, we can turn the switches on, but if the light doesn't come on, it's not much use. So there they are. So a torch can be very useful. This is quite a fancy one. It does sort of different settings. There they are. And you can adjust it. Okay, so there we are. That's my torch there. Okay, so that's one way of light being passed on. Yes, Lisa? A lamp. Well done. Now, I cheated a wee bit. I didn't take a proper lamp, so I'd have to unplug it and get a message from Carol about making a mess and so on. So I've taken this, it's a bit like a lamp. It's a bit like a lamp, you see.
It's a camping lamp.
It's a camping lamp, yes, indeed.
Hang it up.
That's right, you can hang it up in your tent, you see. That's a kind of lamp. Okay, so well done, Louisa. A lamp, that's another one. Any other suggestions of light? Yes. A light bulb. Yes, it takes someone with great intelligence, yes, to recognise the importance of the light bulb. So thank you for that. Yes, there's a light bulb here. Some people sometimes wonder if I've put on a light bulb in here. But there we are. That's right, there's a light bulb there. So we've got a light bulb there. Good. Oh well, we're doing well. Anything else? What was that, Tiny?
Fire.
Fire? Yes, indeed, you get light from fire. Yeah.
You've got that in your bag.
I've got a fire lantern. But, of course, what sometimes helps to light a fire is something like this, isn't it? And a box of matches, which you're hoping. Yes, so there's a fire. So, I didn't quite have it in my bag, but near enough, that's as much as I can manage. Okay, great. So these are all different forms of light. Now, let me see. I'm going to show you some I certainly couldn't manage in my bag. I wonder what means of light I couldn't manage in my bag. We'll find out. What's that? Yes, Lisa? The sun, that's right, there's the sun. And it's actually quite difficult to take a photo of the sun because the sun, if you were to get close, it's so, so bright. And as well as that, as well as it being very bright, what else is it? It's very hot, that's right. And there's a famous Greek myth of two people, a father and a son, that were a they made wings and they were flying up, and one was very curious and wanted to look closer and closer to the sun because he was so chuffed that he could fly. But then the wax melted on the wings and then he just went flying and falling down into the sea. So the sun is very, very hot. This next picture gives you a sense of almost the sort of burning of it that's producing the light, but it's also producing the heat. So the sun is a huge distance away but we can even feel some of the warmth from the sun. So that just shows how strong the light and the heat are from the sun. So we mentioned about the light from the candle, and there's a light from a torch. I don't think it's as good as my torch, but never mind, never mind. And of course the light bulb. There's a proper lamp, please. Are you happy with that lamp there? And light is also a very important theme in the first Christmas story. And some paintings really show that very well. Any idea of what that is a painting of? Jennifer?
It's the light in the sky and the shepherds. It's on the angel host.
Indeed, when the angels came and addressed the shepherds. And you get the impression it was possibly quite dark before, and then the angels appeared, and you get this sense of a shining light from the sky. And of course, there was also the wonderful sound of the angels singing. But one of the angels addressed the shepherds and said, "Don't be afraid, I have good news for you. For today, Bethlehem is a child who has been born. You'll find him wrapped in swaddling clothes, and he is the son of David, the promised one." So that's the light represented in the angels in the sky, shining on the shepherds and the sheep. The sheep are brightened up as well with that same light. And of course, another sign of light in the first Christmas story is the light of the star that the wise men followed to find where the baby Jesus had been born. And it was almost as though that light was a guiding light. Sometimes it's very helpful when it's dark that we can see a light that gives us some direction so that we know where we're heading for and where we're going. And these are two paintings I actually saw in person not that long ago when I was visiting London and I went to visit the National Gallery. And again, you've got that contrast between dark and light. When we think of it, there weren't electric lights that we have in the time that Jesus was born, so it would have been quite dark. But you get that sense of the light of the angels up above and then the light shining from the baby Jesus. So there's Mary with baby Jesus and shepherds there, possibly other visitors, I'm not sure if the wise men are there, but they're gathered and you've got that sense of the light coming into the world. And this picture, it's called the Nativity at Night, very much shows that contrast. You've got the baby Jesus, who seems very small, in the manger, Mary's looking on, there are some angels nearby, and that's probably an angel away in the distance. And again, you've got that sense of the light of God coming into the world and making a difference, as light does. You can go into somewhere that's very dark, and if there's a light, it just changes the whole appearance of the place. That's what we believe about Jesus, that the light representing the presence of God and the love of God comes into the world and makes a difference, brings a change. So what the title I gave here in the audio service was Love is Large. And I suppose the sun is very large. And when we think of God who created the world, the sun, the stars, and so on, we think of God as being very, very large. But in an amazing way, we believe as Christians that this very large God came into the world in the form of this very small baby. And as I've already spoken about, brought the light of truth into the world, the light of goodness into the world, and as well as that brought heat, not quite the same as the heat of the sun, but warmth, the warmth of love, the warmth of care, and the warmth of compassion. And that this same Jesus was to grow and teach us how to love and help others in a very special way. So we celebrate the height, the width, the length, the depth of God's love coming into the world in the baby Jesus. And we continue to celebrate that special love coming into the world 2,000 years on. We're now going to continue in our Christmas celebrations with a song from the choir, O Men from the Fields. I guess that might have to do with the shepherds. Let's continue in our worship and let us sing together the hymn that really expresses what we've been speaking about. Love came down at Christmas. Hymn 316. Jesus coming into the world, but may we recognize and welcome him here and now, and look forward to where he is going to lead us and guide us and provide for us. And so in thanksgiving and in praise, we bring these our offerings and pray that you would bless them, that they might be instruments and channels of the good news of Jesus Christ. Child of the Manger, Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, born for us in the face of violence and terror, touch us now with your love, your healing power, as you give yourself completely for us. Child of the Manger, Saviour, Messiah, sign of our freedom, your birth broke down the barriers, crossed every boundary, included everyone, giving good news for all the people. Touch us now with your good news, opening us to love that crosses boundaries as you give yourself completely for us. We are conscious of many divisions and barriers in the world in which we live. We pray that you would bless those who seek to bring greater understanding and wisdom and a sense of being able to share and learn together. We pray your blessing upon those who are living here in this country, not because it was their first choice, but because of circumstances in the world that drove them to come here. We pray that you would bless those who seek to provide hospitality and welcome and learning and enabling for those who are finding their way in a strange land. Child of the Manger, life shining light into the darkest places, life for every one of us. Empower us to become children of light, children of love, children of God. Touch us now with your true light. Enable us to open ourselves to you as you give yourself completely for us. And in a time of silence, we pray for those known to us going through challenging and difficult times, and we commend them to you in our prayers in this silence. Loving God, we thank you that you hear our prayers and you respond to them in your love and in your wisdom. We remember the words of Scripture, "No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them." Amen. After the service, I hope many of you will be able to come through for a tea or coffee and a chance to catch up with one another. And hopefully we'll see you at the forthcoming Christmas services, but I know it's also a time when some folk are travelling to see other loved ones and family. And if you are away, as well as being here, I wish you a very blessed and joyful Christmas. Let's sing as our closing hymn today, hymn 304, O Little Town of Bethlehem. Thank you. Emmanuel is coming. May the Advent words, peace, hope, love and joy, resound with you this week. And may the blessing of God be with you this day and every day. The blessing of God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit be with you now and evermore.